Hi, welcome to Toronto. My name is SK Lee. Let's talk about magnetic damping. We all know from the famous experiment of Galileo that all objects fall at the same speed regardless of their weights. Here are two DVD jackets. One is loaded with a copper coil, so its lid is much heavier. When they are released together, they fall indeed at the same time. Now, what if we do this experiment near an MRI magnet? Their force cannot be more different. Now go back to Galileo. Under what condition can two objects fall differently? Yes, when there is damping. Here are two glass balls. One falls through water and the other through a sticky syrup. Inside the syrup, the fall slows down due to viscous damping. The fall time is proportional to the damping coefficient. When the loop falls, electromagnetic induction generates eddy current in the loop. The eddy current has a magnetic moment M, and like a compass needle, it tries to align with the static magnetic field. This opposes the action of the gravity, and the competition between the two forces generates magnetic damping. We found a mathematical equation describing the falling time. Magnetic damping is proportional to B0 squared. To test the theory, we measure the fall time at different field strength along an MRI magnet. This is how we did it. First, we move the loop to a desired table position. Then we pull the string to start the fall. We measured the fall time and repeated this at different table positions. And here is the result. Our theory agrees very well with the experimental data. So why is all this important? Ultra-high field MRI has a great potential to image human body at great details. But acoustic noise and vibration inside the magnet increases with the magnetic field. Can we dampen this vibration? We have learned that magnetic damping goes up rapidly with the magnetic field. Can this give us a much needed solution to vibration in ultra-high field MRI? Many researchers are trying to answer this question. After all, the magnetic moment of an induced eddy current may hold a key to a friendlier future of high-field MRI. Thank you for listening.